Greetings and salutations! I'm Janet from World Anvil, and this is our quick guide tutorial for the Articles and Categories interface on World Anvil. Here you can organize your articles and categories, build your world's table of contents, add tags for easier navigation, quickly edit articles, view stats about them, and so much more. Are you ready? It's time to light up the forge! There are several quick and easy ways to reach the Articles and Categories interface. You can find it here on the left-hand menu bar, beneath your world. You can jump there using the green hammer button from any page on World Anvil, even from the view mode. You can also change which world is active here too. And the quickest way, as always, is with the Artemis navigation tool. Use Ctrl-Enter keyboard commands to open up the interface and type List Articles, or even just L R to get you there with just your keyboard. On the left, you have collapsible lists, which show your articles grouped in different ways. You can also see general stats and your to-do list here. In the center, you can search through your world's articles. You can also view collections of articles by selecting the category or list on the left. You can quickly change the state of articles here too. On the right, you'll see more details about an article or category you've selected. You can edit your basic article and category details from here. If you need more space for these three columns, you can collapse the left-hand menu bar. As everywhere on the website, just click the hamburger icon and it'll slide away. Now let's unpack this in more detail. On the Quick List section, you'll be able to see certain articles you want quick access to. Most of these lists are fairly self-explanatory. They're designed to help you finish your articles and get them published, track your oldest drafts, and help you figure out what to work on next. The Storyteller's Secrets, though, bears a little more unpacking. As part of the RPG features, which you can enable or disable via account details, game masters can make a secret note of small nuggets of information they've established with their players. These are called seeds, because they may or may not grow into plot points during the campaign. Viewing your storyteller seeds is a great way to remember what you've foreshadowed, and developing these seeds during your campaign is a sure way to make you look like a genius game master, like you masterminded everything from the beginning. Under Browse by Categories, you'll be able to navigate through all your categories and subcategories. These categories form the basis of your table of contents on your world's homepage. You can also drag and drop categories to rearrange them, or create subcategories. Subcategories are a really excellent way to keep your world organized. We recommend you have no more than 20 articles under each category. More than that will overwhelm your players and readers. Remember, you can always create subcategories and they give extra context as well. You can expand or collapse your categories by clicking on the plus or minus sign. You can also search through all your categories using the search bar. You can add a new category here. If you check this box and have a category selected, the new category will be added as a subcategory of your selected category. If you click on a category, you'll find that the details of it can be seen here in the right-hand column. You can change the name of your category here. If the category is set as a book, that is, to appear on your world's homepage like this, you'll see this book icon. You can set this up in the advanced edit of your category. Quickly change from public to private by clicking the padlock. Private categories won't appear in your world's table of contents. You can add an excerpt here, which is shown when the category appears as a block, like this. If you're a guild member, you'll be able to share private categories, articles, or other content exclusively with your players or readers through subscriber groups. To learn more about subscriber groups, check out our Access Rights quick guide at the top and the bottom. You can add subscriber groups to a category with the green plus button, and remove them by clicking on them. If you're on a mobile device and you can't use the drag and drop function, then expand additional options. Here you can change the position of the subcategory within its parent category using a number value. Refresh the categories to see the change. You can also select a new parent category here with the edit button. Just start typing the name of the parent category and it will appear beneath. Again, This is for mobile users who cannot use the drag and drop function in the categories list. Drag and drop, it's way faster. Finally, Advanced Edit takes you to the full category edit interface, where you'll be able to add more advanced design and more content, and control how your category looks on the world's homepage. On the left-hand column, you can also browse articles by template type. Click on the template type to see your articles of that type displayed on the central column. Guild members also have access to statistics here. They can see their most liked or most commented on articles, their most viewed articles, and the articles with the most words. You can also see your current progress on your world's word count. You can change this word count goal on your world's configuration page under the Settings tab. Some guild members also get expanded stats, showing the total number of comments, likes, articles, and followers of your world. There'll be more coming here soon too. And finally, you'll find the to-do list, which all guild members have access to. This is a great way to keep track of what you need to write next and help your worldbuilding productivity. Clicking on a created item in the to-do list opens the article up at the top right, and you'll be able to edit its settings quickly. For more details about how to use the to-do list, check out the Codex article and the quick guide video linked in the description. In the central column at the top, you'll find the search bar. Here you can search the titles of all the articles in your world. Some guild members also have access to full search. This runs a search for your term not only in article titles, but also in article excerpts and vignettes, the first section of an article's text. Beneath the search bar is the article list. When you first open the Articles and Categories interface, your most recently updated articles will be shown here, so you can pick up where you left off last time. When you search, all the articles found to match your search term will appear here. With these icons, you can choose between the collapsed and expanded view of your articles. Collapsed view allows you to see your articles list more easily and rearrange them. The expanded view gives you more information and options for your articles. If you select a quick list, category, or article type from the left-hand column, all the articles inside will be listed in the central column. To add articles to categories, click the two-line icon on the top left and just drag an article into the category on the left column. Each article can only be in one category, but remember, you can add tags to help navigation in other ways too. I'll tell you more about that in just a moment. Once in a category, you can easily rearrange the order that articles appear. Click the Arrange button and drag them into the order that you want. You can also see a lot of information about each article here in the central column. You can see the article title, the template type, any contained articles, and the category the article is in. All articles show the date of last update, and guild members can see the article's word count. Character articles show an empty rectangle if the character has no portrait picture, and a tiny portrait icon if they have one. If you mouse over the information icon, you'll see additional information about your characters, including birth and death dates, current location, and appearance details. Some types of articles show related articles too. If you've linked one in, like a related organization, species, or ethnicity, they'll show up here too. In addition, you can copy the hyperlink of the article to your clipboard, jump to the full edit interface, view the article in view mode, delete the article, this will ask for a confirmation, quickly publish or unpublish an article, that is, make it a draft, swap between public and private, or swap between work in progress and done. If your article shows as private, you can also quickly add subscriber groups here. As with categories, if you select an article, more information and options appear on the right-hand side. You can see a character's portrait image, or otherwise the article's cover image, at the top. You can edit the title and alter publication, privacy, and work in progress status. You can add or edit the excerpt of the article, which shows up when it's embedded as a block. You can also copy the hyperlink of the article here and paste it into another article to link them together. As always though, the easiest way to do this is using the mention system, at and then three letters. Learn more about that in our quick guide on linking articles together, at the top, at the bottom of this video. Some guild members also have access to the expanded view, like in the Explorer mode. Clicking the expanded view will open the article into the full width of the center and right columns, and will allow you to edit the vignette of the article, the first section, You can also edit the mouse over snippet, here. By the way, this expanded view remains open when you swap between different articles on the left-hand side, or search for articles in the search bar. This makes it the fastest way to edit your articles en masse. Combined with a to-do list, it makes a very quick workflow for getting your articles written, polished, and published. And you can use Quick View to see a simplified view of the complete article. This is very helpful to double-check content or details. You can close the expanded view by clicking on the expanded view button again. If you have articles nested beneath your selected article, you can see them in the contained articles section. These should be reserved for tertiary content only. For example, if you have a tavern building article, you might choose to make a menu document article as a contained article, since you're unlikely to need to refer to it by name. You can edit and view your contained articles here. Here, you can move the article from one category or containing article to another. You can also remove the article from the category altogether. If you do this, the article will appear in your uncategorized articles list. You can also quickly add tags to an article here. Tags are searchable and a great way to create alternate grouping systems within your world. For example, you might have a category called Illusion School Spells, and then tag some spells as Bard Spell or Wizard Spell. You can use another tag to denote the level of the spell, for example, level 1 or level 2. You'll be able to search by these tags to see a full list of Bard Spells, or a full list of level 1 spells, for example. The more specific you are with your tags, the easier it will be for you to find things. Under Additional Options, you'll find options to add or remove subscriber groups. If you're on mobile and can't use drag and drop, you can select the position of the article within the category by adding a position value. Refresh the central column to see your changes. Some guild tiers can also edit the default URL of their article. Guild members can also see the number of likes, words, and views the selected article has. Here you can copy the link of the article so that it appears as a block, not a simple hyperlink. And you can view the article in view mode here, or delete it. And finally, Advanced Edit takes you to the full article edit interface of your selected article. And that's all there is to it. We're so excited about how much quicker you can manage and organize your world-building articles with a new interface. Please let us know what you think of the interface in the comments below, and share your ideas about how it can become even better. We're always trying to make World Anvil more amazing for you. If you're looking for more help, check out our documentation, the World Anvil Codex, at worldanvil.com/codex. I've linked all the articles and quick guides in the description of this video that I've mentioned, so you can check those all out there. Or join our Discord server. That's worldanvil.com/discord, and ask your questions on our help channel. And make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/worldanvil, where you can find even more World Anvil tutorials and tips and inspiring world-building videos and advice. Now grab your hammer and go world build. Related organizations, species or ethnicity, they'll show up here too. Ethnicity! I did it.